Welcome and Namaste to the Sleeping Buddha class. My name is Ralf Eisend. This sleep therapy is a gentle way to deep sleep and contains several elements that support you in your relaxation and meditation. Today, we are using waves again to help you fall asleep faster and improve your sleep quality. How does it work with the delta and theta waves? You may have heard or even tried it as a kid in school that if you want to make a guitar string vibrate without touching it, what you do is play the same tone, for instance with a tuning fork. The frequency from the tuning fork will make the guitar string vibrate. And it works in a similar way here. The alpha, delta and theta waves that I included in the therapy stimulate your brain to tune into this wave frequency. Your brain will learn to create these frequencies by itself again and with repetition produce these sustainably long term. Sleep researchers from the Psychological Institute from the University of Cologne were able to successfully demonstrate these effects in a series of tests with 170 people. Today we are going to do exercises from Yoga Nidra. Wikipedia describes the Yoga Nidra effects as follows. It is among the deepest possible states of relaxation while still maintaining full consciousness. The regular practice has been found to reduce tension and anxiety. The symptoms of high anxiety, such as headache, giddiness, chest pain, sweating, and abdominal pain respond well. It has been used to help with post-traumatic stress disorder and can alleviate stress and improve self-esteem. I spent last night on the rocking little rowboat in the Gulf of Bengal. I was sleeping between the sky and the sea, and I felt as if the starlight was charging me with cosmic energy. I connect with the cosmic life force that we are all part of. Vishnu reminds us of this energy. Vishnu is the all-pervading one. He stands for the omnipresent cosmic life force of which we are part. He is the original force from which everything arises and which vitalizes everything. It is the underlying force of the whole world that flows through everything. By immersing ourselves in nature, we can connect with this energy. It's time for me to say goodbye to Sagar Island and Hariharananda, who has assured me that we can learn everything in life, including healthy sleep. He said, the best way to learn is through repetition. Through practice and repetition, we can teach ourselves all skills. We shouldn't force our sleep, but let ourselves drift, act without force, like water that makes its way and creates a stream bed. We shouldn't resist, but swim silently with the flow, and can therefore achieve goals by using the natural flow of the omnipresent cosmic life energy. In the last episode, we did a basic relaxation exercise, the 4-7-8 breathing exercise. You can do this exercise up to 2 times a day with 4 repetitions. We will do this again in later episodes. Today we will take a big leap and practice parts of Yoga Nidra, the sleep yoga. I start my journey up north with a boat trip. Hari offers me to accompany his brother Gaurav on his boat, who is on his way to the Bihar School of Yoga in Munger. I accept with gratitude and soon sit next to Gaurav in a narrow, long wooden boat that glides through the sluggish water. Yes, now I finally feel like I'm on my way. I've spent the last two nights outdoors and I already feel carefree. The river is several hundred meters wide. It is one of the most important waterways in India. It connects Calcutta with the north of the country. There are mainly ferry boats and fishermen on the river. With every mile we ship north, I leave my daily routines behind. It's good for me to turn my back on the past and enjoy the very moment. The green landscape passes me and I doze off in the heat and enjoy the warm wind. On the first evening of our trip to Bihar, after a long boat ride, we dock at a jetty. We want to do our meditation today here on the wooden pier. I lie down on the warm planks as the sun slowly sets on the other side of the river. Gaurav leads me through a yoga meditation called Yoga Nidra. Gaurav is a teacher at the famous Bihar School of Yoga. He and his brother Hariharananda are twins and were given up for adoption to different families as children and led a childhood in the pain of being torn apart. As toddlers, they got new identities, new names, new parents, and a new home. The awareness of separation from one another remained. The loss of their parents and the loss of their other half stayed with them throughout their lives. Gaurav told me it was only a year ago that the two men met for the first time, recognized each other and realized that they both took the same path in life independently of each other. Although they grew up completely separate in their adoptive families, they both started yoga at an early age and finally bumped into each other at a yoga training for teachers. "We are one now," says Gaurav. "We are united." I tell Gaurav about my journey and my search for exercises to overcome tension and insomnia. Gaurav says, "There's a vast number of reasons that cause poor sleep. They can be physical in origin, related to bad eating habits, or can be caused by a lack of physical exercise, illness or pain. The causes can also be psychological, such as stress, worry, or excitement. Since both the causes and the effects are physical and mental, we should look for methods that consider both sides." The word Nidra comes from Sanskrit and means sleep or non-awareness. Yoga Nidra is an exercise of deep relaxation, the effects of which go beyond the usual idea of relaxation. It's a kind of psychological sleep in which physical, mental, and emotional activities come to rest. It brings freshness to the body and the brain to a state of fully conscious calm. The deep relaxation not only relieves general ailments such as stress and nervousness, but the causes of stress that are buried in the unconscious are raised into the consciousness. Now, let's do this exercise together. Close your eyes and listen to your breath. Perceive your surrounding. Imagine the house that you're in, the room. See yourself from the outside, from above, and listen to your breath again. Breathe in for 5 seconds and gently let go. Breathe deeply and slowly into your belly and let go. Feel how your belly rises and go down again when you let go. Let's focus our awareness to the large body parts and relax them. We start with the legs and feet. Become aware of your legs and feet and relax them. Become aware of your shoulders, arms and hands and relax them. Relax your butt and your back. Relax your upper body, your chest. Relax your neck and head. Inhale and exhale 10 times, counting back from 10 to 1. Inhale and exhale 10. Inhale and exhale. Please continue to 1. I recorded the murmur of the river here on the planks of the jetty. Imagine you lie on the warm wooden planks and feel the warmth of the setting sun on your skin. It shines on your legs, stomach, and chest and face. Stay a little longer here and enjoy this time for a few more moments. Now keep breathing gently. Inhale deeply and slowly into your belly and let it go. Feel your belly rise and go down as you let go. Inhale and gently let go. Continue your conscious breathing and relax your body. Ease up and relax more each time you let your breath gently go. You've accomplished a lot today. You've seen and heard a lot. Now is your time to unwind. You've been thinking and speaking a lot. You've earned your rest. You moved around and worked a lot. You've done enough today. Relax and enjoy this peaceful, quiet moment.